Be silent, Piter, the Baron said, and the laughter stopped as though shut off with a switch. Conley, is it? Vendetta, eh? And he uses the nice old word, so rich in tradition, to be sure I know he means it. You made the peace gesture. The forms have been obeyed. For a Mentat, you talk too much, Piter. The Baron said, and he thought, I must do away with that one soon. He has almost outlived his usefulness. The Baron stared at, across the room, at his Mentat assassin, seeing the feature about him that most people notice first, the eyes. The shaded slits of blue within blue. The eyes without any white in them at all. A grin flashed across Piter's face. It was like a mask grimace beneath those eyes like holes. But Baron, never has revenge been more beautiful. It is to see a plan of the most exquisite treachery, to make Leto exchange Caladan for Dune, and without alternative, because the Emperor orders it. How waggish of you! In a cold voice, the Baron said, you have a flux of the mouth, Piter. But I am happy, my Baron. Ras, you are touched by jealousy. Piter! Ah, Baron, is it not regrettable that you were unable to devise this delicious scheme by yourself? Some day I will have you strangled, Piter. Of a certainty, Baron. Enfin, but a kind of act is never lost. Eh? Have you been chewing verite or semuta, Piter? Truth without fear surprises the Baron, Piter said. His face drew down into a caricature of a frowning mask. Aha, but you see, Baron, I know as a Mentat when you will send the executioner. You will hold back just so long as I am useful. To move sooner would be wasteful, and I am yet of much use. I know what it is you learned from that lovely Dune planet. Waste not. True, Baron? The Baron continued to stare at Piter. Fade Rautha squirmed in his chair. These wrangling fools, he thought. My uncle cannot talk to his Mentat without arguing. Do they think I have nothing to do except listen to their arguments? Fade, the Baron said. I told you to listen and learn. When I invited you in here, are you learning? Yes, uncle. The voice was carefully subservient. Sometimes I wonder about Piter, the Baron said. I cause pain out of necessity, but I swear he takes a positive delight in it. For myself, I can feel pity toward the poor Duke Leto. Dr. Yue will move against him soon, and that'll be the end of the Atreides. But surely Leto will know whose hand directed the pliant doctor, and knowing that will be a terrible thing. Then why haven't you directed the doctor to slip a kinjal between his ribs quietly and efficiently? Piter asked. You talk of pity, but the Duke must know that I encompass his doom, the Baron said, and the other great houses must learn of it. The knowledge will give them pause. I'll gain a bit more room to maneuver. The necessity is obvious, but I don't have to like it. Room to maneuver, Piter sneered. Already you have the Emperor's eyes on you, Baron. You move too boldly. One day the Emperor will send a legion or two of his Sardaukor down here onto Giddy Prime, and that'll be an end to the Baron Vladimir Harkonnen.